Storm Tracker Center with your forecast. How are things looking out there, Court?
Really not too bad. We're starting out in a mild fashion for the valley right now. It's a bit cooler in the mountains, but not all that bad either. Nothing we weren't prepared for. And what we're seeing out there over the next couple of days, a big change of pace on the way. So let's take a look at what we're expecting in your weather alerts. Now, really quickly, I do want to show you Highway 36 heading through the Chester area, dry on the ground this morning. That's going to be changing later this week, and that is one of those areas where you may want to avoid traveling heading through Friday through your weekend, as we're seeing low snow levels heading through for the weekend and substantial snow amounts possible over the next several days after Friday morning. Getting a look at what we're seeing today, though, mild and warm today. Showers possible late today into tonight, not really looking all that likely. And then heavier rain and snow showers moving in Friday, lasting through at least late Sunday, more than likely. Some areas still seeing showers into early Monday morning. What we're seeing right now, temperatures mid to high 40s for the valley starting off your morning, 44 degrees in Redding, 47 degrees for Chico, so really not too bad. This is above average for overnight lows. Higher elevations, this is where we're seeing a drop compared to yesterday. 22 degrees for Alturas, 34 degrees for Weaverville. Yesterday we were in the 30s to 40s. This morning it's 20s to 30s and mid 40s in the foothills, with 47 degrees in Paradise right now. Winds are out of the east up to 5 miles an hour this morning, expecting to stay on the lighter side today. And the showers that we are tracking are mostly just hung up along the coast early on today. And a lot of this green you're seeing is actually moisture that's not hitting the ground. It's just virga in the atmosphere. And then as we expand our look into the Pacific, you can see what's drawing that moisture in. And it's that low pressure area off the coast right now. This is going to start to dive, though, down to the south. And as it does so, it takes with it that threat of showers towards Southern California. Now, again, later today, we could see some light precipitation popping up in areas like Butte or Glenn counties. That's not out of the realm of possibility, but it really doesn't look like we're going to see the main event heading through our neck of the woods. Later today, that's in the Bay Area. By tomorrow morning, that's in Southern California. But we do see a system of our own making its way in Friday morning, ramping up Friday afternoon, and then becoming much more substantial on Saturday, with lingering showers moving through Sunday, but snow levels down to as low as 3,000 feet by Sunday afternoon. We're going to see snow levels starting out between 4,500 to 5,500 feet Friday and Saturday. Now, as far as what we're seeing today, mid to high 40s this morning, low to mid 60s for your afternoon in the valley. Higher elevations starting out in the 20s to 30s this morning, ending up anywhere from the low 50s to low 60s later today. And in your Storm Tracker 7-day forecast, where your weekend's always in view, low to mid 60s with cloudy skies today and tomorrow, but just dry for most of Northern California. Rain returns late Thursday into early Friday. Snow, again, down to around 4,500 feet possible Friday and Saturday, with heavier precipitation moving in on Saturday. Lighter precipitation, but still nonetheless more active weather Sunday. And then we do stay cold but dry out for the start of next week. And Stephanie and Julia, coming up in a few minutes, I'm going to take a look at the latest model data and show you just how much precipitation is expected for that upcoming weekend.